हेलो नमस्कार, आप सभी का स्वागत है सीआईटी एनसीईआरटी द्वारा प्रसारित लाइव इंटरैक्टिव सेशन में। कक्षा 9 के बच्चों के लिए विज्ञान यानी साइंस के इस सत्र में हमारा विषय रहेगा स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एटम। तो आपके मन में हमारे इस विषय से संबंधित जितने भी प्रश्न हो आप ज़रूर हमें भेजें। आप हमें देख रहे हैं ई विद्या चैनल नंबर 9 पर और हमारे एक और आधिकारिक यूट्यूब चैनल NCERT PM ई विद्या क्लास 9 पर। मैं सृजन राजपूत हूं और हमारे साथ यकीनन आज के अतिथि भी हैं। स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एटम को लेकर आपके मन में जितने भी प्रश्न उठे आप उन्हें हमें भेज सकते हैं, लिख कर भी, और लाइव फ़ोन इन के ज़रिए भी आप हमसे कनेक्ट कर सकते हैं। आप अपनी स्क्रीन पर इस समय फ्लैश होती हुई ये सभी जानकारी देख रहे हैं। आप हमें कॉन्टैक्ट कर सकते हैं हमारे फ़ोन नंबर पर, ये नंबर है 8800440559। इसके अलावा आप हमें लिख सकते हैं ऑन dth.class9@cert.nic.in पर। आप हमें जिस भी हमारे ऑफिशियल यूट्यूब चैनल के माध्यम से देख रहे हो तो आप वहाँ जाएं और लाइव चैट बॉक्स ऑप्शन में लिखकर अपना प्रश्न हमसे पूछें। तो इस विषय पर आपके मन में सवालों को समेटें और जवाब देने के लिए हमारे साथ हमारे आज के अतिथि, चलिए उनका परिचय आप सभी को बताना चाहूँगी। हमारे साथ हैं सर डॉक्टर अमन भारद्वाज। सर नमस्कार, हार्दिक अभिनंदन।
नमस्ते मैम।
सर का परिचय देना चाहूँगी आप सभी को। सर डॉक्टर अमन भारद्वाज हमारे साथ हैं, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर हैं केमिस्ट्री के और RIE रीजनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ एजुकेशन भुवनेश्वर। NCERT का ही ये एक विभाग है भुवनेश्वर का, जिससे हमारे साथ हमारे आज के विशेषज्ञ जुड़े हैं। तो सर सबसे पहले तो एक विषय की भूमिका को जानने के लिए आपसे चाहेंगे कि स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एटम हम कक्षा 9 में तो पढ़ रहे हैं, क्या हमने इसे इससे पहले की क्लासेज में भी पढ़ा है, और अगर पढ़ा है तो उसका भी छोटा सा एक रिकैप्चुलेशन आपसे चाहेंगे, और आज हम क्या नया सीखेंगे कक्षा 9 के बच्चों के तौर पर वो भी आप बताएं।
थैंक यू मैम, थैंक यू सो मच। सो गुड आफ्टरनून माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स। सो लेट्स बिगिन आवर टुडे सेशन विच इज ऑन द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एटम। सो बेसिकली द आउटलाइन ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चर इज एंशिएंट आइडियाज अबाउट एटम, देन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट चार्ज पार्टिकल्स इन द मैटर, then we come about the basic models that's come during this course of actions, like Dalton's atomic model, Thomson model, Rutherford's model, Niels Bohr's model, and at last we will discuss the summary about these atomic structures. So basically this is basically the recapitulation that you have already studied in your previous chapter or previous classes, like what is basically atomic theory. So atomic theory was given by the ancient Greeks, philosophers and thinkers. So in 14th BC century, Alastrol will tell that matter is something which is continuous and can be divided into the particles. Then some other philosophers come into the 16th century BC, Leucippus, Decromitus and Epicurus. They tell us that these particles can be divided into further in terms of atom. They called it as atomos, which is a Greek word which means uncuttable and indivisible. Even our Indian thinkers and philosopher Maharishi Kandan also tell us about the same thing, that matter can be consist of tiny particles, or you can call it as Parmanu. So basically, these philosophers or thinkers will tell us about their thinking, but there is no experimental evidence for proving what kind of the structure an atom have. So therefore, this you students, you already learn about the Dalton's theory, which is given in 1803 by John Dalton, which is an English school teacher, that explain the structure of atom initially by using the chemical law of combination. So, we all know that atoms and molecules are the fundamental building blocks for any matter, and the existence of different kinds of matter is due to different atom constituent. So in this, our mind have a two questions, ki either the atom of one element is different from other, or atoms are really indivisible, or we can have something in between it, some subatomic particles are there. So the indication is come from the study the electricity. Whenever you guys understood the electricity, you are able to understood that atom is not an the individual or uncuttable part. There is something which is inside the atom. For this, we can took a simple activity. You just calm your hand here dry hair, then put it some piece of paper. When your comb is near to the piece of paper, they attract it. But if we say ki atom is not cuttable or an individual, then how this charge is coming? It means we have a comb which is, you know, run through our dry hair, that can have an electrostatic force that can attract the atom of the pieces. Means the atom must have some charged particle, and this can be easily understood. In 1900 century, we have find out first subatomic particle, which is electron, given by the J.J. Thomson. Then Goldsmith come prior to it in 1886, discover the discovery of proton. And this after that in 1932, Chadwick will discover the subatomic particle known as a neutron, which is a neutral one. So now we start the journey of how the atom can be evolved through its structure. First, we already, I hope that you guys already understood that what the Dalton's atomic structure. Basically, Dalton said that all the elements are composed of a tiny particle, which is known as atom, and atoms of the same element are identical and different elements are different. And atoms of different element can physically together or chemically combine to form another compound. Any chemical reaction can't change the individuality of any atom. But, you know, after the discovery of this proton, electron and neutron, the Dalton's theory was failed. We have to think beyond it, because Dalton said the atom can't be cuttable, it's the smallest part. Then various scientists are come together and they will give the various models for explaining the atomic structure. The first one come by the J.J. Thomson. In 1903, the J.J. Thomson gave its model based on the Christmas pudding. Just like a pudding, he said the electron is in the sphere of the positively charged pudding, just like the electron is kernet on the spherical pudding. Or you can understand this by taking the example of watermelon. In watermelon, all the red part is considered to be the positively charged, and the black seeds that is sprinkled around the red area is the electron, which is balancing the charge neutrality into the atomic structure. So on that basis, the Thomson proposed that an atom consists of a positively charged sphere and electron are embedded on it, and the negative and positive charge are equal in magnitude, so a atom as a whole is electrically neutral. Then this theory was further explained or further modified by Rutherford. He do a scattering experiment. He choose an alpha particle and strike out in a thin gold foil. So why he choose thin foil? Because gold foil, because of the, you know, the gold can be thinner near about the 1000 atoms of the thickness. And also he choose alpha particle because due to the they are doubly charged and also have a mass of 4u, and they are fast moving particle, have considerably good amount of energy. So expectation is that alpha particle deflect by the subatomic particle which is present in the gold, because alpha particle are much heavier to damp. This experiment gave unexpected result. When he performed this experiment, we got an unexpected result. Like most of the, you know, alpha particle that is going across the gold foil are passed through. Some of the alpha particle are reflected back by the foil by a small angle. Surprisingly, you know, very few out of the particle are rebound. So Rutherford said that this result was almost incredible. As like if we fire a 5-inch shell of a bullet in a piece of tissue and it will come on back. Means you just understand this experiment that you passes the alpha particle and there is an atom which is completely hollow, and it passes the atom without striking, and very few are reverse back within small angle, and very very few can bounce come back with an angle of 180. So he designed such kind of experiment to perform its vision. So what actually the accomplishment did by the Rutherford that most of the space inside the atom is empty because, you know, the alpha particle is passing through without any deflection. Few particles have deflected their parts, indicating that positive charge of the atom occupy very little space. And very small particle, you know, fraction of alpha particle were reflected by the 180 angle means the positive charge and the mass of the gold atom are concentrated in a small volume within the atom.
Yeah, after the studying the both, can we find something common from those theorems from Thomson and Rutherford, sir?
Actually, ma'am, when we are going into, you know, one by one, just like Dalton, who said that the particle is just an spherical ball, he does not consider about any charge neutrality into it.
Clear.
Then we come to the Thomson model. He said the charge neutrality is there because some positive charge is equally distributed and negatively charge is embedded, just like water melon. Then Rutherford said there is no positively charged, you know, uniform in the atom. It's the concentrated in a small area and rest part is covered by the electron or negatively charged particle. So he concludes that, Rutherford basically conclude that the positively charged center atom is called as nucleus, which nearly taken all most of the mass of the atom, and the electron that revolve around the nucleus in a circular path. And he also find it out by the calculation of his experiment that the size of the nucleus is 10 raised to the power 5 times smaller as compared to the size of the whole atom.
That's very interesting. Yeah, please, sir.
Then the, you know, after understanding the basic structure, ki, okay, the atom is something in which we have some subatomic particle like electron, proton and neutron, in which nucleus consists of proton and neutron and electrons are revolving it. But the main drawback that observed it after few years, that if we, you know, any negatively charged electron is circulating in an orbit, does not have a stable because due to the acceleration, some energy definitely radiated out. That means after some time when it revolves, the atom must be unstable or it disappears. The electron is merged into the nucleus and atom loses identity. But in the real world, we see we cannot find any matter that loses its atom. That means there is something hidden into this structure. Then we come to the modern theories. Basically, in the your class students, we have only the Bohr model. After, you know, in your 11th, you also understood about the wave mechanical model that's given by the Schrodinger. But we will stick towards the Bohr model, which basically describe the particular path for the revolving of electron. In the previous Rutherford model, you observe that electrons are moving around it, but there is no defined path. He did not define the path of it. He said ki electrons are, you know, ghum raha hai, ek charge, positively charged particle hai, uske around wo ghum raha hai. He did not give the particular path. But in the Bohr's model, he provide the path that's called the energy level. So the most important thing that, you know, discovered by the Niels Bohr is that he described a discrete orbital. Discrete orbital, basically you understand in a simple way that only those allowed path in which an electron can revolve. So while revolving in the discrete part, the electron does not lose its energy or does not radiate. So if they don't radiate, they don't lose the energy, they don't merge into the nucleus. In that manner, we can understand that the atom can have something which have a nucleus and the electrons are revolving around a predefined or specific path, which is the discrete orbital. So the atom, we can conclude the Bohr's model in that way. The atom has a positively charged nuclei at the center and most of the mass of the atom is in the nuclei and electron is revolve around the nucleus in a special defined path, which is discrete orbital. And these discrete orbital known as the energy level or shells, which is defined by capital K, L, M and so on, or numeric you can also give 1, 2, 3. So while revolving in this discrete path, they does not radiate. Now I just summarize the things because it's 20 minutes already passed on, so you can understand the atom. No, we started with the ancient time where the philosophers say that any matter can be, you know, divided to form an atom, but they did not describe it any experimental evidence is there. Then first a good experimental evidence was given by the Dalton in 1803 that a atom is a spherical thing, in which he does not describe about the charge neutrality or charge thing. Means subatomic particle ki he did not talk about. He did not discuss about the subatomic particle, just said the matter can be divided into the particle and particle will subdivided into the atom, and atom is come from atomos, which is uncuttable or indivisible. After the 100 years, 1904, around Thomson came and gave his plum pudding model or Waterman model that we just described, ki in which he said there is a positively charged particle or positively charged which is uniformly into the atom and negatively charged is embedded. Through this he said the electron is electrically neutral but they have a charged particle. After few years, 1911, Rutherford came and he described that the positive, by his, you know, famous scattering experiment, said the mainly charged, mainly mass of the atom is concentrated into the center and that is positively charged, and electron is somewhere, you know, around it, which is revolving. But he did not talk about the path on it. So that main drawback with the Rutherford model is that the electron, if continuously revolve in that manner, can radiate energy and it give an unstable atom that cause for an disappearance for any atom. But it does not happen. That means after 2 years back, 1913, Bohr model came and Niels Bohr explained that electron were moving into their particular well-defined path that is called the discrete levels, energy levels, that defined by K, L, M, capital 1, or 1, 2, 3, you can understand any way, in which the while revolving in these part, electron does not remove or does not radiate or does not lose its energy, so they can form the stable. So our question is clear, that our answer is clear for that question, ki atom have a electrical neutrality or not. So atom have a electrically neutral, but they have the subatomic particle which are charged particle. And while electron is removing into a specific path, does not radiate into that way, the atom is stable. After you know this study, you will further study in your 11th class that a Schrodinger model that I skip because it's little bit harder, in which you find out that how the electron filled it into a particular orbitals. That's the orbital concept. When Rutherford Bohr tells about the orbit concept, and then we are coming to the orbital, or we are discussing about the how the quantum mechanics that helps to describe the complete structure. Even in today's scenario, I am just discussing about the three things, three subatomic particle inside the atom. Today we have more than 200 subatomic particle we able to find out inside the atom. So it's very complicated to understand the atomic model, but initially we have a basic idea that atom something is that in which the nucleus is there, and nuclei is comprised of proton and neutron, and electrons, which is negatively charged particle, are revolving around a specific path. I hope you guys enjoy this learning and able to understand the basic structure of atom. That will helpful for your further study.
Yeah, sir. Can you please elaborate for our viewers what are the most important question we get from this chapter in the examination purpose?
Ma'am, for examination purpose, we can have, you have to describe the Rutherford model. Means what is the Rutherford model, because you know the main turning point are come into the atomic structure when the Rutherford model is done. And also there might be a question come, what is the difference between the Thomson and Rutherford model, and at the last there may be asked about the this Bohr Niels Bohr model and how this Niels Bohr model can explain the things.
और वी नीड टू ड्रॉ और जस्ट नीड टू गिवन द थ्योरीज अबाउट दीज राइटर्स बाय गिवन टू अस.
मैम बोथ द थिंग्स मीन्स बेसिकली फर्स्टली यू एक्सप्लेन द बेसिक एसेंस कि हाउ द स्ट्रक्चर कैन बी एक्सप्लेन बाय द पर्टिकुलर साइंटिस्ट एंड आल्सो राइट डाउन द स्ट्रक्चर दैट हाउ यू नो स्ट्रक्चर इज लुक लाइक लाइक आपका जॉनसन थॉमसन मॉडल था इस वाटरमैन लाइक मॉडल आपका उसके बाद में देन वी कम टू द रदरफोर्ड मॉडल. सो उसमें आपको एक इलेक्ट्रॉन बनाना है बीच में सेव करना है इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर अराउंड इट. सो इन दैट मैनर यू कैन एक्सप्लेन इट्स नॉट अ पर्टिकुलर पिक्चर यू हैव टू ड्रॉ यू जस्ट नीड टू एक्सप्लेन इट
या
बाय
और
योर ओन लैंग्वेज.
In further studies, what we are going to learn in class 11th in this the structure of atom topic.
Ma'am, basically in class 11th, we have a the students are understood that we are coming into the quantum, understand the quantum mechanics there, and in the quantum mechanics, they understand the Schrodinger equation hai, through which he know ki that just I described the electron or nucleus is there and electron are revolving around a particular path. In that, rather than a particular path, there is a probability of finding electron. Rather than a specific spherical, you know, circular path, electron can have a cloudy form in which the electrons are can be find out. Like they can be distributed like s orbital, p orbital, d orbital. They understood दैट एटम में एक स्पेसिफिक इलेक्ट्रॉन को हम यहाँ नहीं पा सकते कि यहीं मिलेगा. द इलेक्ट्रॉन कैन बी एनी वेयर वी कैन प्रिडिक्ट अबाउट द प्रॉबिबिलिटी दैट प्रॉबिबल इलेक्ट्रॉन माइट बी देयर और माइट बी देयर विच विल एक्सप्लेन देयर इन द हायर स्टडी और फर्दर क्लासेज.
That's very clear, sir, and thank you so much for this fruitful, informative session presented by you. We are with Sir Dr. Aman Bhardwaj. Sir is an assistant professor in chemistry from RIE Bhubaneswar NCERT. So sir, we learn a lot things in this so we are so many things we learn in this particular session. And sir, agar hum kuch true examples ki baat kare jo ki hum real life mein structure of atom se observe karte hain, so can we take a little for this?
Explosive and it will harm so much. So when I just explain that these some atomic particle, atom bomb means you are giving the so much energy to a particular material, you are breaking the atomic structure of it. It will give a splashing out the things. So atom bomb basically atom ka structure nahi aapne dissolve destroyed kara, wo kya hai aapka jo matter hai aapne atom mein jud ke banaya hai, jo bhi koi matter aapne liya. If you are giving so much threshold or so much energy into it, it will spreading out. सो होता क्या है इफ़ यू अंडरस्टैंड कि अगर आप 1 ग्राम कोई भी एक पर्टिकुलर मटेरियल ले रहे हैं उसमें 10^23 एवोगाड्रो नंबर के हिसाब से आप सोचिए कितने एटम्स कनेक्टेड हैं. सो इन दैट एटम इफ वी आर एबल टू गिव दैट मच थ्रेशोल्ड टू अ पर्टिकुलर स्पेसिफिक यू नो मटेरियल सो दैट विल एक्सप्लोर लाइक एनीथिंग. सो दे विल कनेक्ट दैट पॉइंट. सो ये नोबल Alfred Nobel will you know discover this atomic bomb and he gives the name on that basis and also you know he is a very rich man on that his name he you know donated some amount on which we get a Nobel Prize. Nobel Prize bhi unhi ke naam pe milte hain. So I think he connected with that way.
या थैंक यू सो मच फॉर दिस आंसर सर. और मुझे लगता है यहाँ बच्चों को एक और संदेश देना भी ज़रूरी है कि हमने स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एटम को जाना है एक एजुकेशनल पर्पस से, ना कि हम इसको एक हैज़र्ड मीनिंग में आप सभी के सामने रख रहे हैं. एंड थैंक यू सो मच टू डॉक्टर अमन भारद्वाज. थैंक्स अ लॉट सर.
थैंक यू सो मच मैम फॉर कॉलिंग. थैंक यू सो मच.
यहाँ बच्चों आपसे एक और अनुरोध करना चाहेंगे कि आप सभी एक बड़ी कक्षा में यानी कक्षा 9 से हमसे जुड़े हुए हैं और आप सभी जानते हैं कि आम चुनाव 2024 भारत में कई राज्यों में हो रहे हैं और कई राज्यों में अभी होने को है. ऐसे में आप अपने घर में जितने भी बड़े हैं उनसे अनुरोध करें कि वे अपना कीमती वोट ज़रूर दें. हम CIET NCERT द्वारा प्रसारित एक और लाइव सत्र लेकर बस कुछ ही मिनटों में आपके साथ होंगे. ये सत्र होगा एक वेबिनार जिसमें ET NICT उपकरणों के श्रृंखला में आज एक नए उपकरण को हम जानेंगे. मैं सृजन राजपूत यहाँ आप सभी से चाहूँगी अनुमति. आपका दिन शुभ हो. नमस्कार.